What's going on, workforce? Brian here.
Chris here.
And today we're diving into some MMO news, especially as it relates to 14. We're talking FanFest, we're talking its live event schedule, we're talking about our role in that. But first, Chris, who's today's shout out? What do we got? What do we got for people?
So today's video is going to be brought to you by King Zephyr.
Yes.
King Zephyr, we're giving away the ability to have a YouTube video shouted out to you. So thank you, King, for all your support and hanging out in the community.
Any hidden phrase that you're hiding in this video?
Oh, I got a hidden phrase in here as well.
Okay.
You'll have to stay to the end of the video. Remind me.
All right. Well, and chat, remind me as well. Filming these live, guys, Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. And I join in Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 2 if you guys want to come hang out with us on Twitch. We got a lot of cool stuff that's coming up, guys. This is going to be a great year for MMOs. But let's kick it off with Final Fantasy XIV's FanFest. If you guys have not seen the news, they are going to be canceling the in-person of like any kind of attendance due to the state of emergency in Japan. This really isn't news, but I just wanted to highlight that for everybody because this is just what's been dropping this morning, and I just wanted to kind of pass that along. But more than anything, if you have a question for Yoshi-P, now is the time to get those in for FanFest. So from the 22nd, which has already passed, to the 29th, which is coming up this week, you can submit a question, and I'm going to have the link in the description below. Just note what they're going to be doing with this one is that you're going to submit it, and they're also hoping that you can either ask it via Zoom. So that's going to have hopefully a little bit more personal experience rather than, I guess essentially kind of them just reading questions out of a hat. So if anybody hasn't seen that, just note that is coming up, and they're looking to take about 40 participants for their questions. So guys, hopefully if there's a burning question that you want to ask about glamour, I'm sure that's going to be what ends up being the most of it. The bulk of this though, Chris, is FanFest. We have a schedule. That means we have times. That means we can start to tell people what our plans are. And so I've got that up on the screen right now. Let's focus in on day one. Chris, let's start with the keynote. What's our plans and when can people expect it?
So the keynote comes in the evening. Mm-hmm. I don't remember the exact time central, but
it's central time. It's going to be 8 p.m.
8 p.m.
Yeah. He called me up. He's like, Brian, you're in trouble.
PSO. We will have dinner. We will have our hot tuna melt on rye. We'll be ready. We'll have our caffeine on hand. And the goal there is to be ready to go. We will be live early. Mm-hmm. Brian and I are working on a guest. Benny from Comic Storian has said that he would love to be there with us. We don't know what time he can be there for because this is a Japanese game. This is the Japanese Fan Fest is the only one we're getting, which means it's held in a time that is convenient to be in Japan.
I got bit by the time zones because I was in here.
8 p.m. Yeah. Through like sunrise is when these are happening. So we will be live sometime before then. We haven't totally nailed down. We'll know that as it gets a little closer. Probably somewhere in the ballpark of like 1 to 2 hours early is I think what we've been kind of tentatively considering. And then we have some events planned around the house, some ways to bet your points, maybe some giveaways planned. We've got some stuff planned to make it exciting, be showing Brian's gameplay and my gameplay for that portion on a pre-show. Brian will be live over on Ginger Prime. I'll be live on Twitch, and then I will host the show long into the night. The keynote, guys, remember, we'll pick up off where the showcase was. So we will open our keynote with a trailer. That trailer will likely be longer than the previous trailer because there were probably things that trailer that had to be cut because they were things we did not yet know from patch 5.5. So there will be little game play snippets. They won't spoil a new player because they won't know what they're looking at. But those of us that are paying attention will go, oh, I remember that now. That's recent. Mm-hmm. So that is how that will start. Then we will somewhere in there get our second job reveal. So we will know what our new melee job is. We think is sharing gear with Dragoons.
Yes. And so when you look at the time, 2 hour block starting 8 p.m. Central time. And like I was saying, like Chris called me, he's like, Brian, you're in trouble because PSO2 New Genesis beta is also happening at that same time.
Same time.
So we'll be focusing on 14 and then I'll be diving in at some point in New Genesis. Maybe we'll finally get that monster sponsorship or I'll just be drinking like hardlining coffee for that weekend because it's just going to be incredibly nuts. Here's where it gets fun. You know, so we have that from 6 to 8, that's Pacific time. So 8 to 10 Central is the time zone that we'll be communicating in the rest of this video. Then an hour later, how do you like Heidelin? This is going to be the Japanese community team will be sharing delightful insights into the world of 14 from the live venue. So there's an hour gap. What are we going to do? We're going to play games. We're going to be teaming up with you guys playing some Final Fantasy 14 if you're still up because this is starting to get kind of into the late hours. Then from there, on still focusing on day one, after that's going to be an hour. And then after that, they're going to have a 30 30-minute break, and then they're going to dive into the development panel, and this is going to go from an hour and a half, ending here at 2 a.m. Central Time. So that's going to be kind of fun. And then from there, they're going to be doing a live from Yoshi P's room, taking place 30 minutes after that. So 2:30 Central going to 3:30 a.m. Central, and then ending in a piano performance. I don't know how, like, what Chris's plans here. We can't obviously stream the music of that, but we can be hanging out playing games if we're not passed out exhausted.
what do you think? Our plan is we'll wrap it up there. We'll have that the video of that playing in the background to remind people the event is live if they want to go listen to that. We can't, for DMCA reasons, show it. We don't have that right. So I encourage you to go listen to that. That is a wonderful time for any of you that have not been to FanFest to enjoy the evening wrap up. Historically, during the music portion, that has been when the digital portion is wrapped up and then they wait till the next morning and everybody just kind of hangs out in person. So it's to mimic that. And then we will actually, if we still have the energy, go ahead and film our thoughts of the first day at that time. So we'll film that live if we're still alive. Otherwise, we will pass out and we will wake up the next day. When is day two's event start?
Day two kicks off with a letter for the producer live. This is going to have a focus in on 555555 and then the road to like 58 and a lot of really cool little things tend to be revealed as a part of this live letter. That's kicking off at, they have it at 6:50 p.m. PDT, so that's going to be 8:50 p.m. So roughly right before 9 o'clock in the evening. So another day has gone in this case. So then it's going to be followed. That's going to run all the way up to 10:30 p.m. Central Time. And then from 11 p.m. Central Time, they're going to do their Glamour to Showcase to Life. And that's going to run for an hour. Then after that, they're going to do the live Q&A. This is going to go from 12:30 a.m. Central Time for an hour all the way to 1:30 a.m. Central Time. And this is where Yoshi P is going to be answering the questions. This is what we talked about right at the start of this video, diving into those things, getting those questions answered and more. Really cool to see that this is going to be a live Q&A, really trying to bring that sense of community that will obviously, like, no matter what, like when we look at this last year, this is going to be felt and this is going to be the most interesting thing to see. And I'm curious as to what of anything from this digital fan fest translates forward into physical and digital in that regards. Because honestly, I think that's going to be the best thing to come out of that is the fact that they could probably do both. We got three more events that on day two. Like this is going to be a busy weekend, guys.
It's a big day. So you'll be jealous from the first day. You'll come in with your caffeine and your hot tuna melt on rye, and we will be ready to go. It's going to be a long, long day. It's going to be a very long day.
I think I just found the phrase.
We're going to stay all the way through the end.
All right. So Flashback with the Cast is kicking it up next. This is kicking off at almost pretty much 1:45 p.m. Running for a good hour and 15 minutes. Flashback with the Cast. Members of the 14 voice cast are going to look back at key moments from the game. And then finally, from an event perspective, Who Wants to Be a Gillionaire? Kicking off 3 a.m. to 4 a.m. Central Time. And you're going to be able to play along with the Western Community team, 14 content creators, as they team up to face off in a fun trivia game show.
And then I assume that's people like Ethis. People that would win.
Bring your A game.
My money's on Ethis. Ethis and Anonymous. Let's do this.
Let's go. And then it's finally going to conclude with a band performance, and that's going to be 4:30 a.m. to 5. I'm trying to do math translation. 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 5:50 a.m. With the live band performance from the Primals. So piano concert day one, concert with the Primals day two.
Now, the VODs of this will be up on Twitch because Final Fantasy does not own 100% of the ownership of all of their music. There are songs in Final Fantasy XIV where they share ownership with other groups. And so they don't have the rights to release that for free. So when it's an album sale, they can split that on the back end. But on Twitch, they have gotten permission this time to have that performance live. In the past, we have had the Primals not be allowed to be streamed. This time they do have permission to stream, but much in the same way that World of Warcraft had Metallica play, the VOD portion might cut that out based on that ownership. They have said portions of the FanFest will not be available in VOD. I have to assume the Primals is part of that. So if you want to see the Primals perform live, you've never had a chance to do so, I encourage you to do so. They play their clips from time to time, but they're very careful in which parts they show, because I imagine that portion will be taken out of the VOD. That's going to be a freakishly early in the morning concert for us. We will once again be hanging out and we'll have the footage up, but we will not be able to hear the audio because we don't have those rights.
So that is going to be what is planned, what is scheduled for the events, and we're going to be taking part in those. And then during the gaps in those times, we're going to be teaming up, probably trying to run some dungeons with you guys if we have the energy. If you guys have the energy, really, it's going to be a matter of kind of trying to maintain that momentum. There's going to be a lot of fun things to be discussing, so hopefully you guys want to come hang out with us, whether you're a Twitcher or if you're somebody who prefers YouTube. We should have you covered and to be able to get you that content that you need. And then we'll be able to summarize that stuff for you guys over on Work to Game as well. It should be a pretty jam-packed weekend. And along those lines, I'm going to try to make sure I've got the energy, the sleep schedule, and then I hand off my mob of kids to grandparents and things like that, so I don't have to sit here and worry about trying to bounce in and bounce out, because I'm going to have to be knocking out some PSO2 New Genesis as the beta is going on that weekend, with a release for that game coming in June. Honestly, the best gift that anybody gave me is that, because now I know that the release is happening there and I could carry that all the way into Endwalker. I'm not going to have to sit here and worry about Phantasy Star at Endwalker dropping on day and date and then somebody be like, you got to choose, Brian.
I will be live before the FanFest event through after the FanFest event both days, period. Mm-hmm. I will handle it.
Yes.
Brian will be here as much as he can allow, because it is possible Brian will have to set aside part of his energy for some PSO2.
Yes.
Because it's a limited time beta.
It's not like, oh, and then on Monday.
I'll just do it after.
Nope.
No, it starts when FanFest starts. It ends when FanFest ends. So what are you going
to
do?
Oh, man. He woke me up to that. I got my second vaccine shot and Chris called me after stream. And he's like, Brian, hey, I was talking to stream guys.
I wasn't going
to
bother you.
But I got some bad news for you. Like, what happened? Everybody okay? He's like, yeah, like PSO2 New Genesis beta is actually happening because the time numbers. I was off. I was like, oh, I'll play PSO2 New Genesis that day because you'll take off stream because we're going to be doing that thing at night. I'll just make it a whole event out of it. And then we'll go right into Final Fantasy. And it's like, oh no, Brian, they start at the exact same time. All right.
So stream that week, just to kind of show kind of how we're doing that for those of you at this point wondering where our coverage will be. That Monday and Tuesday, I'm going to go ahead and take a weekend so that I go in fully rested. So I'm going to take 2 days and not be live. I've got some other projects I want to work on for YouTube, so I've got plenty to do here. But I'm going to take off that Monday and Tuesday. So I have a nice 4-day weekend going into the week. We'll start that Tuesday and I'll go straight through. On Friday, our stream has obviously been moved into that evening stream, and so our time slot will shift. So I will not be live during my typical 8-to-2 shift because I'm going to be live on a different 8-to-2 shift. So easily just as long, it's just going to get moved back 12 hours.
Yes. Well, anyway, on those notes, like hopefully that's what you're kind of hoping for, excited for. Let us know. I essentially by the 14th, like everybody should have their pick. Is it Reapers, a Templar? Is it, you know, what's the say on the job? Because we won't have any questions after the event, after the live keynote, which is going to help answer a lot and put a lot more questions in our minds as we get ready for this next expansion. To this universe. So guys, let us know what you think, what event you're most excited for, and if there's anything that you want to run with us on live stream when we're playing and kind of having those gaps that we have to stay awake. It's like, all right, 30 more minutes, guys. What can we kill? What can we take down? So anyway, that's it. That's it for this video, guys. If you'd like to hit subscribe. Chris, on that note, though, I think I know the hidden phrase.
I've been trying to use them more than once.
Tuna on rye.
A hot tuna melt on rye.
Yes. I only picked it up because she said it twice.
I'm trying to work them in twice to see how much I can get by with.
It was the second time that I was like, I bet that's the phrase.
Yeah, because Chris doesn't eat cheese.
Well, it wasn't
so
the
why
cheese.
Would there be a melt?
Well, it was that I was like, well, it's Friday. I guess like if you're taking like Lent into the year, I was like, fish on Fridays. It just seems like a natural thing. But it was the second time. It was the second time that I was like, that doesn't fit. I was like, oh, that's really good for Chris, his being a Catholic Jason. Just like, all right, I'm gonna keep fish going on Fridays. Anyway, I thought that was funny. So thank you. Who gave you that phrase? Do you remember?
I don't. I haven't been writing down who gave me the phrase.
All right, at some point we'll see about that. But yeah, thanks so much for that awesome phrase. Chris has got tons in his holster, so be sure to hang out with him on stream and see if you can't have him work in some ridiculous things to say. And I think I heard one, but I'm sure you said after that, I probably will forget, and I guarantee it by the fact that the list is so long.
I don't remember if I didn't have it written down.
Yeah, exactly. So, all right, chat. All right, everybody. Thanks for being here. Thanks for hitting those follow buttons. Thanks for hitting those, you know, just likes and even dislikes. Either way, all those dislike ticklers out there, we love you. Be sure to check out more content. But for Work to Game, my name is Brian.
My name's Chris.
Thanks for watching. Hopefully you have a great day, and hopefully we see you on our next one. But until then,
take care.